Cake Masters magazine is one of the UK's leading cake decorating monthlies. It includes fabulous step-by-step cake tutorials, recipes, expert advice, competitions, interviews, design inspirations, and so much more. You can order your 12-month subscription to Cake Masters magazine right here for just £35 and with free UK P&P. To order your 12-month subscription, either visit creatingcraft.tv or call 09056 480 480 and quote the item number on your screen.
Hello there and a very warm welcome. Good afternoon. It is 5 o'clock on a Sunday, which is our brand new destination for everything cake. This is only the third episode in the Cake Academy. And if you've missed the first two, don't worry. You can actually watch those back on our website, creatingcraft.tv. But every Sunday at 5 o'clock, it's a whole hour dedicated to what has to be one of the most popular crafts, not just in this country, but globally, cake making and cake decorating. Now, if you go to our website, there's actually a Cake Academy section there. You'll find all sorts of top tips from some of the best demonstrators and well-known demonstrators in the country as well. And each week a different guest comes along and shares their inspiration, shares their ideas and shares their top tips too. And we'll also have some of the best products to help you with your cake decorating along the way as well. So sit back, have a cup of tea or whatever on the brew and enjoy the hour with demonstrations from the lovely Cassie Brown. She's our guest this particular hour. And it's all about the Cake Academy for the next 60 minutes here at Creating Craft. So what's your favourite thing? What's your favourite cake? What do you like to decorate most? Well, every week we have an expert guest. This week is the lovely Cassie. Welcome back.
Hello, lovely to be here.
Good
Thank
to
you.
See you. Now, tell us a little bit about yourself. You've been obviously guesting with us at Creating Craft for a little while now, but you're very much an expert in your field, and you judge as well competitions, don't you?
I do. I started many years ago doing exhibiting, doing competitions and different things. Really enjoyed it, got the bug, and now I'm proud to say I'm a judge, which is fabulous. I'm judging on Friday at the cake exhibition.
More on that later on.
Yeah, that's going to be huge. But when I started demonstrating and making flowers. A lot of people know me for the airbrush and what I do with the airbrushing, but actually my roots were making sugar flowers.
Right.
So I'm very pleased to be here to show you.
Well, this hour is dedicated to, in particular, making flowers out of all sorts of different mediums. But just look at how gorgeous these cakes are. And I think an awful lot of people are certainly daunted by how you make a flower, how you make something so beautiful out of maybe sugar paste or whatever. Well, this hour is dedicated to all those techniques. If you want to record the show, please feel free. Do remember, this is one of the first shows ever at Create and Craft that we've been able to put on what they call Series Link. So if you are watching us on Sky, that's a facility that's available to you. If you want to just hit the Series Link button, that will record every single show every Sunday at 5 o'clock, and also any other shows that are kind of related to the topic of cake decorating during the week. You'll find it all there on your planner, which you can watch back again and again and again. Now, for those of you that are brand new to Create and Craft, and we are aware that there are literally thousands of you joining us each week that perhaps wouldn't normally think of tuning in, maybe you follow Cassie on her social networks and that sort of thing. We've had Rosie, of course, as well in previous shows too. There are lots of you that are tuning in just for this show and wouldn't normally watch. So let me just explain how things work. We are going to be talking about how to do all of these fantastic techniques. And what you'll find is on the screen that way, how many years have I done this? On the screen here, it's what we call the L. Okay, now that gives you all the product information. And what will happen is during the show, as Cassie uses different things, for example, at the moment we're talking about the airbrush and the compressor, which Cassie's famous for bringing us, that shows you the item number for it, the fact that it's on flexible payments as well. If you want FlexiPay, you can spread the cost interest-free. In this case, into three flexi payments of £30. It gives you the price, it gives you the Craft Club members price as well, which is that little purple slip there. So you get 10% off, of course, if you're in the Create and Craft Club. And the all important numbers, of course, down the bottom, the phone number, and of course the website if you'd like to order it that way. And everyone, even if you're brand new, can order what we're showing you and demonstrating in the shows today. So the website is www.createandcraft.tv. The phone number, of course, 09056 480 480, if you can order that way as well. Okay, well, let's talk about what we're going to be using. And the compressor is something that you bring to us regularly. And it is, it's like airbrushing, but for cakes, which is quite unique, isn't it?
Yeah, all my colouring. I'm very well known to colour everything. Do everything white to start with, and then I just use the airbrush to colour up. People say that doing flowers, you need to use the dusting brush and all the dusting colours. You can still do that, but today I'm going to be showing you how to use the airbrush because it makes stunning effects. And all of these flowers here, you can see some of these aren't really bright and gory.
No, not at all.
They're very delicate.
They're very, very realistic and very natural looking, aren't they?
Yeah.
Before we get into the demonstration, just to let you know, if you do want to buy your tickets to Cake International, which is at the NEC in Birmingham, we actually have them for sale on our website at a slightly reduced rate. So it's cheaper to buy them in advance from us, especially if you're in the Creighton Craft Club, you get your discount off the tickets as well. Yeah. And that's for Friday, Saturday or Sunday next week. Cassie's going to be there. We've got a massive stand there as well. And it's right next door to the craft show, which is on the Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. So if you want to do both of them at the same time,
Brilliant. You could
do that. So yeah,
I would urge people to do that, because I do know days where it's been sold out and people have been turned away. Mm. So please buy your tickets in advance.
And get there early as well, because there's always a big, big queue. It's a massive thing across the UK, cake decorating, and that's why this is a dedicated slot every single Sunday, 5 until 6, for all the top tips from our top experts. All right, I'm anxious to learn, where do we start?
Well, first we're going to do some tulips.
Okay.
So I thought it'd be nice to bring the spring in already. We work a little bit ahead of ourselves, don't we?
Why not?
So these are the tulips I've made here, some sugar tulips. Really simple to do. I've got all the equipment you need. First thing I'm going to talk about, though, is looking after your equipment. Because you buy these expensive cutters, and then you get them home and you use them on your board and they don't work.
Right.
And then I have phone calls saying these things aren't working. Well, actually, it's because you're not looking after your green board here.
Okay.
So this is a simple non-stick board. And let me tell you, this is the one I had since I was 13. So once you buy one of these boards, they're like going to last you a long time. So
provided you look after them.
Exactly. Yeah. So don't put it in the dishwasher. That's a big no-no. So all I've got in here is literally a lump of Trex. So I'm just going to get a lump of Trex on my finger.
Mm-hmm.
Massage it into the board. So never put a wet, damp cloth on your board, because otherwise it's going to warp.
Does it have to be that brand, or can any other fat do?
This is just Trex.
Right.
Ignore the label. I've just put Trex in there.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So any white fat. Right. Any white fat.
Vegetable fat, yeah?
Yeah. But, I mean, Trex is very good. And as you can see, that comes up like a brand new board. Now we get a piece of tissue, and then I'm going to wipe across. I dread to think how dirty this is going to be. Oh, not too bad.
No.
Don't do this every
day. You surprised yourself,
eh? I did. I don't do this every day. But you can see the fat comes off and it keeps your board nice and moist, and it'll last you a lifetime.
So all your petals and things won't stick to the board, otherwise they would, wouldn't they? Probably.
I'll go into that in a minute.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and there's a little secret there as well. You actually want them to stick to the board.
Ah.
On certain occasions, yeah. So there we are. So we get that all nice and clean, and now that's ready to work with.
Excellent.
So never put it in the dishwasher, because it's going to warp. You're going to get your cutters. When you press them down and they don't cut out perfectly, it's not because the cutter's bent, it's because your board is warped.
Ah, right.
So I hear that quite a lot. Right, so what we're going to start doing straight away is use flour paste. Now, have you ever heard of flour paste before?
I've heard of it. I don't think I've used it before.
You've never played with it. It's very different to modelling paste, sugar paste. So sugar paste is what you would coat a cake with.
Mm-hmm.
Flour paste is what we make these very delicate flours. And you can see they've rolled out very thinly.
Yeah, I think I've worked with sugar paste before, but not this. So.
Right, okay. So let me get this going for you. A little bit of Trex on your fingers.
Mm-hmm.
I just rub it all over my fingers, and then I can work with my... Now, can you see it's very stretchy?
It is, actually, yeah.
Yeah? So yeah. This is the Wilton flour paste. And I must admit, it's a good one to use.
Now, we've got a great relationship with Wilton. We are the only outlet in the UK that has the entire inventory of Wilton products. And they are on our website right now, createandcraft.tv, and you'll see every single product from Wilton available in this one place. So if you've maybe bought Wilton products before, loved them from different places, and you've been frustrated that you couldn't get everything that you needed because they only stocked a few lines or something like that, we have the entire available inventory at createandcraft.tv, which is fantastic.
Wonderful.
So we're in association with Wilton, which is beautiful.
Lovely. Mm. So what I'm doing here, I'm just using the lid of my Trex to keep over the top.
Okay.
Now that's going to stop it from drying out, because if you don't cover your paste, it'll dry out while you're mixing this one.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the first thing to do. Now, I'm rolling the paste into a long sausage. And then I'm going to squash it down so it looks like a flat worm.
Right.
Now, notice I will keep picking it up and moving it. Now, this here is what they call a cell pin. So it's basically a very, very thin rolling pin.
Mm-hmm.
But it does the job beautifully. So I'm going to press down and roll out.
Do you often do like one-on-ones with people? Do you have like classes and tutorials?
I do, yeah. I demonstrate and teach. I travel all over. Yeah, which is... brilliant. And you know, I learn just as much as they learn.
Right.
Because you always get someone, I thought, why didn't I do that?
Right.
Why didn't I think about that?
So really, you've got like an hour's worth of tutorial with Cassie for absolutely nothing today, just by tuning in and recording the show and watching it back.
Right. So can you see there, that's coming lovely. Now what I'm going to do is start working to the end of the petal. So I'm leaving a ridge in my paste because I'm going to put a wire in that.
Okay.
So we're going to get that nice and thin. You see how I'm pressing down there? And the bonus of using the green board, as I go thinner, can you actually see the green board through it? Now, this is why I only work with green boards and I don't use the white ones at all.
So you can see how thin it's gone.
Yeah. You know what I was saying about in sticking to the board? If I was using my scalpel now and cutting out my shape, I would leave it stuck to the board because then you don't get a dragging motion as you cut. But I don't want that today. I'm going to use cutters. So I'm lifting it, putting it back down. And then these are the tulip cutters. They come in a set of two. Mm-hmm. And I'm using the smaller one first.
Tulips actually are a flower that you don't often see, or I don't often see, in cake decorating. You see your carnations and your roses and things, but tulips not so.
So press down, give a little wiggle, and it'll be stuck to your cutter. Now, if you put your finger around there, that's going to get the fluffy edge off. Make sure it's cut beautifully. Mm-hmm. And then that's done. So we put that to one side.
How many petals make a bud?
We need six altogether. Right. So with this set, we need three of each. Okay. Three of the smaller and three of the large. And the reason I'm doing this is because this is how I would normally do it at home. I'd make three at a time. So.
Now, presumably this paste as well, because you're using so little of it, it'll last you a very long time.
Do you know, that's a huge amount of paste to get in a bag. I mean, look.
What's the quantity in there?
Look at that. That's going to make.
465 grams of gum paste. And that's what it looks like if you're looking for it on the website. There we go.
Well, let me tell you, to do that bouquet there, I haven't even used a quarter of that.
Really?
Yeah. So it's going to last a long time.
And once it's open, is there a special way of resealing it? Or is it a resealable plastic?
It's resealable, yes. So make sure it's always sealed. Because as soon as the air hits it, that's when it's going to start drying. So do be careful of that. Mm-hmm. So press down.
See, I'd be scared that they're too thin, but they're not, obviously.
No, never be scared of that.
It's almost like it's almost translucent. It's like you're looking at parchment or vellum. You can see through it.
That's right, yeah. And that's what makes it realistic then. Mm. And when I first started doing flowers, I remember going up to the local pub where my dad was, and I took these flowers. I think they were called bittersweet, poisonous flowers. And I took them into the pub, and I said to my dad's friends, "Look at these, I've made these." And everyone was smelling them, thinking they were real.
Really?
And because they were poisonous, they were going, "They're poisonous flowers, you shouldn't be touching them." I was going, "No, I've made them in sugar." And that kind of spurred me on then, because of the reaction you get from that. Mm. You know, it's amazing, and that makes you want to do more.
Well, when these actually dry out, once you've made them, do they become brittle, or do they still stay quite pliable?
No, they're very brittle.
Right.
So that's what you've got to be careful of.
Right.
So now I'm getting a wire. Now, again, we've got a bundle of wires with some tape, which is an essential kit. So I'm going to cut this into three, so... One, two, three. Mm-hmm. Now, in this little bag here, I've got some corn flour. So I'm just going to rub a little bit of corn flour on my fingers.
Because then it's corn flour you use on the moulds as well, don't you, very often?
That's right, yeah. It's a non-sticking sort of agent. Now, I'm going to put that ridge along my finger, and then this wire here is going to be gently pushed. Now, what I'm actually doing is squeezing with my finger and my thumb, and while I'm squeezing, I'm pushing with my other hand. Mm-hmm. So that wire is going up just over halfway.
Okay.
So does that make sense? Yeah, that's why we left that nice long ridge going up the centre.
Is that quite a tricky technique to master? Or you may have to practice a few times.
I'm going to say no, because this is how I was taught. And I personally think this is easy for me. When I do a lot of workshops, a lot of people can't do it. And if not, there's plenty of other ways. You can buy boards with ridges in them. Mm-hmm. So you can actually roll your paste out, put your wire in, and then put the paste over the top again. So you're sort of sandwiching the wire, and then cut it out, it's done. So there's lots of different ways of doing it. And I always say, it's finding the right way of doing it. There's no such word as can't in this industry.
Everybody's different and everyone's got their own favourite ways of doing things.
Exactly. And it's just finding which way is going to work. Because also the heat of your hands. Mm. Do you have really hot hands or cold hands?
This is certainly one of the most popular pastimes in Britain today, cake decorating. And there's obviously quite a few shows responsible for this massive resurgence in popularity of baking and decorating and so on. But everyone can do it. If you've got the right tools and the right knowledge, everyone can achieve great results, can't they?
Exactly. And it's well worth doing. I mean, the results afterwards. So this here is the tulip veiner. And this is really important because this is going to make it look even more lifelike. It's going to give it the veins that it needs. So I'm placing that in the centre.
So this is a silicon mould, yeah?
It is, yeah. Double-sided, so you get it both sides. Gently press down.
Now, if you do go for the cutters today, you're also going to be getting the mould at the same time. So
can I just say...
Total realism. Look at that.
The difference.
Yeah.
Huge difference there.
It doesn't matter if they're not the same size as the mould, just the veining is the important thing.
That's right. And whenever you're buying moulds, a little tip for everyone to save money, always buy the bigger mould rather than the smaller one, because you can always do things smaller inside, but you can't go bigger, yeah, if that makes sense.
Good point.
So always buy the biggest one you can get your hands on. And this is quite a nice size, actually. And this also does the throat of an orchid as well.
Mm-hmm. Also, we'd love to hear from you in the show. We are live. Obviously, if you're watching this back after it's gone out, then we're not. But we're live at 5:15 on Sunday afternoon. So if you'd like to email in and tell us why you're watching, are you brand new to Creating Craft? Have you just heard about this maybe through the social media or whatever? We'd love to hear and get your comments every Sunday for an hour, 5:00, the Cake Academy. But you can email studio@creatingcraft.tv and we can say hello to you. Any comments that you've got? Have you only just started cake making and decorating? Tell us what you think.
Send some pictures in. Love to see pictures of what people do. So here what I'm doing now, this salpin that I'm using has got a pointed end. Now, if you haven't got one of these, you can use a cocktail stick.
Right.
That will do the job as well. And what I'm doing, as you can see, is making it go slightly frilly at the edges. And you see how I keep picking it up so it's not sticking?
Yes.
And I'm going all the way around the edge, doing it with all of them. And then once you've made these three, you're going to make another three. So you have your six petals.
Mm-hmm.
But this tulip I've done here is a bit like a parrot tulip. So what I've also used, the Wilton set.
The tool set.
It's the tool set. Mm-hmm. This is really good. This is like a Dresden tool. Now one end is slightly thinner and more pointed. That's the end I'm going to use. And I'm actually going to drag the paste off onto the board, if you can see that.
Now these tools have made an appearance, I think I'm right in saying each week, because they're cake decorators' must-haves.
Yeah, there's so many different uses for them, that's the thing. And there's so many different tips to them, they're really, really good. Double-ended, so we're doing this with all of them. Can you see the difference again? Just by tinkering, just by pressing gently there, off the edge. There we are.
So when you see how, it's not difficult. When I saw the finished tulip earlier on before the show started, I thought, how on earth does anyone make something that looks so realistic and so believable? But these little techniques.
Yeah, and it is really easy. And if you can't do it in the particular way I'm doing it, then you might be able to go to the show, watch another demonstrator do it. Mm. They'll do it completely different to me, but you'll be able to do that way.
Sure.
Or you might prefer this way. So everyone's different. Now what I'm going to do is get each one, and just very gently, using the big ball tool here, just soften that. Can you see what that's doing? It's making it curl slightly.
Mm-hmm.
So if I do it on this one as well. So it's flat at the moment. I'm curling it just to make that end come up a little bit. See it cupped. Like so.
Were you self-taught?
A lot of the time, yeah. I used to enter a lot of competitions. And when I do a competition, you always go hoping for gold. You never know. And then, as the judges, you know, you get your awards, you always hassle the judge afterwards. And this is what I recommend you do, and I get a lot of this at the show, people come and talk to me. Why did I get gold? I thought that one was going to get gold, mm-hmm. It's better than mine. Or why have I only got bronze? Why have I got commended? And they'll give you tips. So, okay, the leaves aren't perfect, shape them like this. Try using this cutter, try using that technique. So a lot of my knowledge has actually come from judges,
mm-hmm.
and their different information.
And you were saying as well that this cake show next week at the NEC, you've got about 1,000 entries in the competition, is that right?
Yeah.
Wow.
That's going to be amazing. I can't wait to see it all, to be honest.
How can you judge 1,000 different entries?
There's a lot of us. There's a lot of us doing it.
Right.
And, it's going to be fun. So I'll be judging on the Friday.
Right.
But then I will be on my stand Friday afternoon. I'll try and get back. And then on the Saturday and Sunday, I've got a main demonstration in the demonstration theatres, but unfortunately it's sold out. But I am demonstrating on your stand.
You are.
Three times, I think.
And we have a massive stand there as well, all dedicated to cake decorating. So if you want your tickets for that NEC next Friday, Saturday, Sunday, they are on our website. You can buy them now in advance if you'd like to. But as Cassie said, get there early because there's a lot of people chomping at the bit.
Yeah, that's a must. So what I'm doing now, as you can see, I'm actually bending the wire and the paste all in one go. Did you see that?
Mm-hmm.
So you're bending the wire and the paste, so you've got that nice L shape, and that's going to give it the cup shape that you need at the bottom.
Right.
And then I'm just literally putting them in this little piece of foam here to dry a little bit. Now, here's some I've prepared earlier. I won't show you how brittle they are just yet. We'll wait and see if they break.
How long have they been in the stand for, drying out? A little while?
I've got one missing.
Have you?
I think. We'll come back to that. Right. So these, I literally did them an hour ago.
Okay.
You can't do them too far in advance because you want them still to be a little bit pliable, a little bit movable.
So an hour after you've made them, they should be just the right sort of consistency to work with.
So then you have to figure out which ones are the larger ones. And then what I'm going to do is straighten them up and then bend them right at the back here. Now, this is another tip I learned from a judge, because you don't want to show that your wires are in there.
Right.
So bend it right back like so. And we're going to do this with all of them. You have to be very, very careful at this point because they'll very easily break.
What a great hobby and pastime to have, though. And think about you've mastered it, which, as you can see, if you're following the tips and the techniques that Cassie's showing you, shouldn't take too long. You'll get commissions after commission, I'm sure.
Yeah, and it's so, as I said, it's such enjoyable to get people's faces. Let me see, is it one of these? Yes, it is, isn't it? It's that one. I hadn't got one missing at all. Right, so now what I'm going to do is go to colouring them. So we line them all up. They're all ready. Move things back a little bit, because then we're going to go to the airbrush.
OK, now this is something that Cassie brings to us at Create and Craft regularly. It is a very, very popular tool to have. If you think of airbrushing, you think of maybe cars being resprayed, possibly in card making as well. But this is actually designed for cake decoration, putting food colouring into the little knob at the top, or the little nozzle at the top. And you get three primary colours included with it as well. Details of it are on the screen right now. And there's three different pressures as well, isn't there?
There is. So we turn it on, it goes to a high, we press medium and low. That slows the airflow down, makes it easier to control. Here's the colour well. I'm going to mix colours. Now, I'm not going to go into too much basic stuff because I know I've covered it 100 times before when I've been on air. But we go 1, 2, 3, 4 drops of yellow.
And this is just food colouring, yeah?
It's airbrush food colouring.
Airbrush,
yeah. And 1, 2, 3. Yeah, do be careful what you put in the airbrush. You don't want anything too thick.
Right.
So be careful. Give a little wiggle.
Again, the website will have all the different colours that are available from Cassie.
And then we spray. Now, can I just say, that's the first green that came out. And now we've got a more natural green because I've put the brown in. So it just tones it down. Mm-hmm. Flowers, you don't want them to be gory and bright. You want them to be quite natural looking. So we're going to bring the petals over. And it is a quick way of dusting, really. So if you've got a dusting brush and you can just do it normally. So what I'm doing is starting from the wire.
And I've done shows with you before, I've had a go with this.
Yeah.
The tiniest amount of pressure on your finger is all you need to make this work.
So as you can see, we're just... Now, these flowers have got stamens in them. I've got to be honest with you, I haven't done the stamens.
Right.
I've been a bit naughty, but only because... They're very time consuming. I have done them for competition work. But something when you're doing sugar flowers, think about how much people are paying you. Mm. Because you don't get a lot. I mean, that on its own, you're probably talking about 2 days' work. Mm-hmm. And people aren't going to pay you 2 days' work just for the flowers own. So you do have to be careful. And sometimes taking little shortcuts. So stamens in the centre, if you're not really going to see them, that's something you can cut out.
Right, fair enough.
But again, if I was doing a competition... I wouldn't dare.
Would you recommend practicing on just ordinary copier paper if you're new to this sort of technique?
Yeah, if you've never used an airbrush before, and the DVD that comes in the box, that'll talk you through all of that.
Oh, great.
Yeah, so it's all on in there. So can you see I'm doing very gentle lines just up the centre.
It's kind of less is more, really.
It is, very much. And I'm barely pulling back the trigger to do that. Now, once we've done that, I'm going to get rid of all that green. What colour should we have? Should we go with red or yellow?
Yellow.
Yellow?
Yeah. Producer said red, I said yellow.
So oh, right. Sorry, producer.
Yellow's one of my favourite colours, that's right.
He wasn't fast enough. So, just make sure it's the right colour coming out, that's really key. Now again, can you see that's really bright and gory?
Yes,
you wouldn't really get a flower that's that colour. So again, count your drops in there. I've already put about 5, so 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And then I'm just going to tone it down with one brown, that's all it's going to take. And that's going to give me a nice golden brown colour.
Do you use this airbrush machine religiously all the time for your cake decorating?
Everything,
it's a must
have. Yeah, it is, yeah. And the thing is, I'm just going to make sure I've got the right colour there. That's it. Can you see
it's
how
lovely,
it's toned it down?
Yeah. The sunshine yellow.
And doing this now, if I was doing these in colours, and if I break one, have I got enough paste in that particular colour? All these silly little things, and you have to make so many extra ones. Mm-hmm. As using the airbrush, you don't, because it's all white, it doesn't matter.
True.
So you can make 100 white roses and then just airbrush them whatever colour you want. rather than, I've got 10 red and 2 blue and 3 pink and 5 yellow, mm-hmm. and so it goes on. Now,
so start with a blank canvas, start with a white, and then just use the airbrush machine
exactly.
to bring the colour in.
So can you see how I've gone darker on the edge? I'm just going round the edge. And you notice I'm doing the inside as well as the out. So don't think you're not going to see the inside, because you will. One of the famous sayings when I was doing competition work is cover up your mechanics.
Right.
Because you think people can't see it, and people can. So I learnt the hard way there. So very gently.
Very realistic, though.
It's starting to come to life now, isn't it? Now, because it's crinkly, I am lifting it up and moving it more. If it was a flat petal, I'd just go around the edge. Mm-hmm. But I want to make sure I get into all the nooks and crannies. I don't want to miss any of it. Yeah, are you going to come to next week's show?
Yeah.
Are you?
I'm there Thursday, Friday, so I'll be there Friday.
Oh, fabulous.
Yes.
I'll come and say hi.
I'm going to be in the main craft, the main card craft area, and then the cake is next door, the cake show's yeah. next door, so I'll be fitting between the two probably on Friday.
And people will be amazed how much it overlaps, how yes. much the cake and the craft show overlaps. Quite often I like the craft shows because it gives me inspiration on the cakes and vice versa. Mm-hmm. So it's really good. So there we are. So these are time consuming, as I've said.
Oh yeah, but
well
look
worth
at what you get
it.
At the end of the end result's amazing.
Yeah, well worth it.
And also think about how much you would pay for a cake to be decorated like this. Cakes like this would be hundreds of pounds. You know, once you've got these techniques down and you've got the right tools for the job, you've got the right paste and all of that that we're talking about and covering on each of these shows every week, you could do it yourself. And the sense of satisfaction,
yeah,
you could even turn it into your career like you've done.
Definitely. And I always said when I was younger that I didn't want to just do cake decorating. I wanted to go that one step more and help other people do cake decorating because the world's your oyster, really. Yeah. You can go for it, use your imagination. So what I'm going to do here now is pick the three centre ones. Oh, and this that I've just got out is called florist tape.
Right, I thought I recognised it. Yeah.
Yeah, you've seen this before? I think it comes in the bundle with the wires, actually. Mm-hmm. So we're going to put three of these together.
Details for the wires and also the tape is on the screen right now. And again, everything is actually photographed and it's there for you to see if you go to crankcraft.tv. If you go to the website right now, while the TV's on or whatever, you'll see everything that Cassie's using in the show, all the offers, all the cutters and the moulds as well for the veining of the leaves, the air compressor machine. Everything that we're showing you in the show is there for you to see. And you can pop them into your basket and, of course, then check out with a debit or a credit card. It's as easy as that. If you've never shopped with us before, couldn't be simpler. And then you've got the Cake Masters subscriptions as well. We've got the Renshaw sugar paste there too. Everything that we're using, the Tylo powder that everyone swears by. Are you a massive Tylo powder fan as well?
Depends what I'm doing. If right. I'm doing sugar shoes, then yes. Depends what I'm doing.
Not for flowers. You don't
no,
need it for flowers.
I don't know. No. Not if you buy a good quality paste.
Right.
Then you'll be fine. So I've just taped that wire up. Don't worry if you've missed that, because I am going to do it with these three. So your first three, you want them to kind of interlock and fold in together, mm-hmm. like I have done there. And then what I'm going to do now, you stretch the tape to release the glue. When I first started using this, I thought it was very odd stuff.
So stretch it to actually make it sticky?
Yeah, because I thought, well, it's not sticky, so how's that going to stick? I never got it. No. But then when you stretch to release the glue, it actually sticks to itself. So that's how it works. Very, very clever stuff.
Good job you told me that, because I wouldn't have realised.
Now, I like to do this when they're a little bit wet, because then you can move them into position more. So then we're going to put the outer petals. Make sure he's in the right place. And you have to be very, very gentle because they will break. Mm. So we have got to be careful. And then the last one.
Look at this.
So it's coming together now, isn't it? And then as you can see, I hold it, I'm stretching with this hand. And as I'm stretching, I'm twisting with my fingers. Mm-hmm. So we twist all the way down. There we are. And then we look at it. And this is where we have to be very careful, but we just tweak. So we're just moving it around and putting it into the positions.
And remember, flowers, we always say this, flowers aren't perfect. You know, nature's not perfect. So it doesn't matter if it's not quite symmetrical or whatever. It's just got to look natural and real.
How's that?
Thanks. Love it.
You can have that.
Isn't that gorgeous? Have a good old close-up look at that. And remember, all of these techniques, you'll be able to watch back again. If maybe you've just got in and thought, oh, I forgot, or I got stuck in traffic or something like that. You can, of course, watch this show back. If you go to the Cake Academy section, you can see episode 1, episode 2, and this show, of course, obviously, after it's finished, you can watch it back at a later date as well if you want to. Now, a few things that we've actually been showing you and offering you. We've got the details for the air compressor, which we can give you on the screen right now. Now, that comes with, at the top there, that red little banner says FlexiPay. Now, that's there for you if you want to have FlexiPay. If you don't want to have it, you can pay for it in full. That's absolutely fine. If you're in the Create and Craft Club, it is £89.99. If you're not a member of the Create and Craft Club, I thoroughly recommend you join. It's only £20 for the whole year. That then gives you at least 10% discount on everything you buy going forward, whether it's cake-related or card-related, whatever it might be. So £99.99 if you're not in the club. If you are, though, it is £89.99 and three Flexis as well of just £30 over three payments. The first payment today, plus of course, the PMP. You've got a DVD from Cassie as well, featuring all those decorating techniques, and also, of course, you've got the three colours. Now, we also moved on and showed you these as well earlier on, the tulip cutters and the veiners. Now, they come all together, and that's just under £20. New today, this. That is the item number 357768. Always jot that down. That's the most crucial number of all, because that will make sure that you get exactly what you're after. So you've got the cutters, and you've also, of course, got the veining moulds as well. You get two of those veining moulds and two of the cutters as well for £17.99 if you're in the club. Now, the wire and tape that Cassie's just been using to create those wonderful tulips. Remember, you've got to stretch that tape to activate the stickiness of it. And you get all of those wires as well. Brand new today. This is £13.49 to club members and £14.99 if you're not in the Create and Craft Club. 357759. And as I mentioned before, we are the only place in the United Kingdom where we stock every single Wilton product. Everything that they produce is on our website. You'll find Wilton stockists all over the country, but they only usually stock a selected number of their products. We've got the whole inventory on the Wilton page, actually. If you go to createcraft.tv, you'll see it there. That's the ready-to-use gum paste that Cassie made those fantastic petals out of. 351034. And also, this is a firm favourite. Every week we bring you the Renshaw flour and modelling paste, perfect to use with some of those moulds that we've got in the show as well, which you'll find on our website. And that's a 250 gram in white, and that is only £2.69. It is all in this week's Cake Academy. So, Cassie's our guest, a regular familiar face on Create and Craft, bringing us, of course, the air compressor, which is one of the main things that you bring us here to the channel. And we're talking flowers, a whole theme of flowers today. We've shown you the tulips, which are these just here. Incredible, absolutely realistic, without any shadow of a doubt. What are we doing next? Are we moving on to another flower?
That's the one I've just done.
Excellent.
I'll put that in there to add to it. Right, so next we're going to move on to the cosmos, which is this one here, the cosmos flower.
The pink one.
Well, they're all different shades.
Ah, right. All of these are the same.
Sorry. Forget you can't see very well on that side, can you?
Yeah. So all of these here, as you can see, these are the cosmos. Where do you start with this? Is it a similar technique to the tulip?
Or? Very similar. Now, the trickiest thing is putting that wire in. Once you've mastered that, then really you can turn your hand to anything in the garden.
Right.
So I've gone out and I've brought a cosmos flower and I've looked at it and thought, okay, I want to make it. I look in my toolbox as to what I can use or what cutters are similar and what veiners are similar, and then we move on. Mm-hmm. So the biggest mistake people do when I'm doing workshops is they use too much paste. So now I'm only going to show you how to use one.
So we're using the same paste as before?
Wilton flower paste for this, yeah.
That one.
So can you see I've got a tiny piece of paste now compared to what I had last time? Mm-hmm. And I know that this is way too much, actually. So then we're going to squash it down the same as before and always make that ridge. That's very important. So can you see I'll always lift and then we stretch that paste. And you can see here I've cut a wire. Now the wires are different gauges. So the higher the number of the wire, so 30 gauge, the thinner the wire.
Oh right.
The lower, like an 18 gauge, would be very strong, right, which would be what you'd use for roses. Mm-hmm. So I'm using a 28 gauge wire for this, and I did use the 28 gauge wire for the tulips as well.
And in the wire packs that we showed you a minute ago, they all come numbered, so you know exactly which one.
They do, yeah. So all you do is look on the back here, and you'll see that there's a little number, 26 gauge.
Right.
Says it all there for you.
Okay, good.
Yeah. So it's quite good. So what we're going to do is roll this again. Remember, really nice and thin. And the thinner you can go, the better with this. Dare to go thin, that's what I always say. When I first got taught this, I was always told you should be able to read through it.
Right.
So you should be rolling your paste thin enough. Let me just try it and see if I can.
That is incredibly thin.
Oh, you see, I'm getting really thin.
It's almost
thin
like tracing
there.
Paper, so wafer thin.
And then you should be able to see words through it.
Yeah.
That's what you should be doing with flowers. Mm-hmm. Anything thicker than that and they're not going to look realistic. So just keep making sure that that's nice and thin. Another thing is make sure that ridge is really thin because you're only putting that very fine wire through it.
So it doesn't need to be too high.
You don't want it to be really chunky and thick. Now I'm actually using the same cutter that I've just used for the tulip. Mm-hmm. So it's the smaller one of the two. One's got a crinkly top and one's got a rounded edge.
Right.
So I'm using the rounded edge one for this. Make sure that paste isn't sticking to the board. And then we're just going to press down, give a little wiggle. That's what makes sure it cuts out. And there it is. So there's our one petal. Now you need 8 of these all together.
Okay.
But you can do one at a time like what I'm doing. Again, a little bit of cornflower on your fingers.
It's incredible to think that the same cutter is going to make this particular flower compared to the tulip.
Yeah, and it's very different as well, isn't
it? Totally different looking, yeah.
Very different. So again, I'm squeezing with my fingers. Now let me just show you. If you accidentally come out, look, and you think, oh no, don't throw the petal away.
Right.
It's fine. If you're sewing and you go in the wrong hole or you accidentally prick your finger, what do? You come back and then you go back in again. And what I'm doing is when I go back in, I'm squeezing.
Right.
So you can't see that hole, it's gone.
Okay.
So that's, it's as
simple as that.
It's
not the end of
the
world if you do pierce it.
No. Which you're going to. Let's be honest, it's going to happen at some point. It's just knowing how to fix it. So again, I'm using the same mould as well.
Mm-hmm.
But it's what we do afterwards is going to change it completely. So there's our basic petal. Now what I'm going to use are these fabulous scissors. Now these are the serrated edge ones.
Mm-hmm.
And I think you've got these on the website as well, haven't you?
We have.
So all I'm going to do now is chop the top off. Like so.
Wow.
Now doesn't that change it? You can see I've only cut a tiny piece off.
And if you haven't got those scissors, I dare say you could do it by hand manually with straight scissors.
You could, yeah. You could probably buy the cutters, but I'm a strong believer that when you buy something, try and think of 3 uses for it.
Mm.
And, you know, they're just a pair of scissors. They're not much at all.
No, they're not much money at all.
And they're really, really good. Now, once we've done that, I'm going to put it on my, on my hand. Now, this here is called a ball tool because mm-hmm. it's very large. So what we're going to do is gently press. And can you see how the petal starts coming to life?
Now, the Wilton tool sets are, again, on the website right now. We've got everything, remember, from Wilton, everything that they actually produce.
There we are. So can you see how that's give it life now?
Yeah.
It's just made it more realistic. Secondly, just give it a pinch at the bottom, because don't forget this is a petal, and petals, they grow from the centre and come up.
Mm-hmm.
So give it a nice little pinch, and then leave to dry.
So again, about an hour before you can...
Maybe not even that. I mean, I have wired these up still quite wet.
Right.
So half an hour, we'll be fine.
And you do how many of those?
8.
8 of those?
We need 8 of those for that.
Right.
So once we've done that, we can move on to colouring. Go on, what colour would you like these? They're going to be another fight.
Actually, I'll let my producer choose this time as I kind of over... What colours have we got?
We haven't got much, actually, out today. We've got yellow, we've got red.
Should we do red? Orange? Has he wanted red last time? Let's do red this time. There we
okay.
go.
So we're going to do a red. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You could have had a violet, actually.
How about violet? Yeah, violet. He says yes to violet.
Yes to violet. Violet gets the thumbs up. You've got to let them think they're in control, haven't you?
Absolutely, yeah.
Kill me for that. Right, so get rid of all that excess colour because I didn't clean it beforehand.
Mm-hmm.
Make sure there's nothing in there. And then we put a couple of drops of violet in. Now, I'm going to put 2 drops in just to rinse out to get rid of all that excess colour.
Mm-hmm.
And then what I want to show you is 2 drops. 1, 2. Spray to make sure it's the right colour. Can you see that dirty colour coming out first? And then that's better. Now what we're going to do is just very faintly go over the petal.
Just the tiniest amount of pressure on your finger, that's all you need.
And can you see that? Can you see the difference there?
Yeah.
It is very, very gradual. And I'm going to actually go darker in the bottom so you can see there.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe darker just around the top as well. But then that's it. I'm not going to do any more. So that's roughly where I want my petals. So very, very delicate. I'm barely pulling back on the trigger.
If you were to make them too bold, they just wouldn't look real.
And the thing is, once you've wired them, you can go over again and make them darker mm-hmm. if you want to. So it's something that isn't going to change. Don't forget to do the back as well. And we're doing it very gradually.
Once you've actually finished and you've done for the day and you want to pack everything away, do you just flush the airbrusher through with water at the end of that?
With water and then with cleaner. And right. Again, that's all on the DVD, so they'll be able to see how to do all that. So it's just a little bit of cleaner in there, tissue at the end, blow bubbles, all done. And then you're ready for it. But to be honest, I don't put mine away. Mine's out by the kettle permanently, and it really is. You can ask my husband that. Because he keeps telling me I'm taking over the kitchen. Can you believe it?
Never.
No, I know, it's wrong.
I think if anyone deserves to take over the kitchen, you do. It's your livelihood, isn't it?
So I've only now just run out of colour. So just putting another drop in there.
Because when you consider you're only putting a couple of drops in at a time, or a few drops in at a time, it goes a long way, doesn't it?
It does, yeah. So as you can see, and very, very gentle. So the point of this, I'm just trying to show you, you haven't got to be big and bold with it. You can be very, very gentle. And then the back. Okay. So now we've done all those, and they are slightly different shades, it doesn't matter. So now what we're going to do is get another wire. Again, it's only a 28 gauge wire. Mm-hmm. Move all of those to one side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I've missed one.
Isn't it great to know, though, that everything that you need is available in this one place? And even though the show is only one show a week, 5 to 6 every Sunday, all of these products will be on the website right the way through 24/7. So you can at any point see what's been on the Cake Academy shows. And also, if you go to the Cake Academy section of our website, every Sunday at 5, there we go, look, and you can find out more about Cassie, what she's used in the show as well, the Wilton special. You've got a 10% off offer there, yeah, with a special
That's
code
good.
With the Wilton collection. Loads and loads and loads of things to get stuck into and enjoy. There's a gallery as well to give yourself inspiration. If you missed a lesson, you can watch back any of the shows, the previous two shows. So it's all there, crankcraft.tv.
Right. So now what I'm doing, I've done all the petals, they're ready.
Yep.
I've got these now. These are called stamens. Mm-hmm. So these are what's going to be the centre of the flower. You can buy them. You can buy them already done. You can make them, but you'd go crazy doing it. Some of them I do make, but these ones I've just brought in. So what we're going to do is fold. I've got a little bunch there. And then we gently fold them in half. Now keep that loop there, because then I'm going to push the wire through and back on itself and twist. So they're going to keep secure. And then I need to bring my tape in, to just because as you can see at the moment, they're all going to fly everywhere. They're not secure. So stretch to release the glue, and then I'm just going to tape up. And it doesn't matter with this particular flower if some of them are a little bit longer than others.
Again, yeah, nature's not perfect, so...
Exactly. And people that try and do the perfect rose or the perfect flower, you'll go crazy. You really will. Because I've tried.
We're getting some emails in as well today. Holly, hello, Holly. Thanks for getting in touch with the show. She says, I love watching things like this. It gets my creative juices flowing. I've never tried making sugar flowers, but after watching this, I think I'm going to give it a go. And that's what the show's all about.
Lovely.
Giving it a go.
Yeah.
Showing new techniques and so on. And don't forget, you can series link if you're a Sky viewer. You can series link every single show, so it will automatically record, even if you're not in on Sundays at 5 o'clock. This is Belinda, who says, hello from Twickenham. First time tuning in and enjoying watching talent, creativity and sharing. Kind regards. Thank you, Belinda. Lovely to know you're there. And make it a regular date, if you can, every Sunday, 5 o'clock, for Cake Academy.
Very good. Lovely. So, you can see I've taped it up. Now what I'm going to do is just open them up a little bit. They don't want to be so tight. So just make them a little bit more flush, like so. And then we're ready to start tape. Now, the one thing I didn't mention, this tape is quite thick. You're never going to need it that thick because it'll just make your stems really thick. And flowers don't have really thick stems. So with a little pair of scissors, I just cut it in half.
Oh, right.
You can get a knife and cut it in half. I've seen people with all sorts of contraptions trying to cut this. I still use the old-fashioned way of scissors, cutting in half, it does the job. And obviously it'll last you twice as long, so it's really good. Stretch to release the glue, and then we start putting our petals on. So we put them right to the top, you can see right up there. I'm going to attach, make sure that that's anchored on well.
And again, that's the stretchy tape to activate the glue.
Yeah, that's the florist tape. And then I'm going to start adding one after the other. And can you see how I'm feeding one just behind the other? Like so. Bring the tape around. And this is where you want them slightly wet still, so that you've got movement there.
When are they completely dry then? How long would it take for them to be completely
Do you know, it depends on the atmosphere in the house and also the heat of your hands. And this is why I say try different pastes, because some people will get on with this great, some people won't. Mm-hmm. So it depends on the heat of your hand and how hot it is in your house.
And how close you are to the radiator.
Yeah, all of these silly little factors make a huge difference.
While you're doing that, I'll just read another email that's here from Dee Harper in Crowborough. She says, hi, Dave and Cassie.
Hello.
I'm a City and Guilds qualified sugar crafter from 1992 and also teach. Definitely. I love passing on my love of this craft and seeing others become hooked. Currently, I'm going to be teaching a group of ladies how to make, bake and decorate their own Christmas cake. We'll be using patchwork cutters to make a poinsettia garland on the top of the cake as decoupage, then using the same designs for brush embroidery using royal icing. By the way, my sister Trudy is a newly trained British sugarcraft judge going to the International Sugarcraft Exhibition at the
NEC. See you there. Lovely.
Absolutely. Loving your demos, Cassie. Learning new techniques. So good to see how it's done. Going to be teaching spring flowers next year, so watching your airbrushing with keen eyes. I haven't tried it, but tempted to purchase the tools. That's what the show's all
Definitely,
about.
Show
you how, with the right tools, you can create a wonderful result at the end of it.
So now what I'm doing is taping all the way down. Now that's something you must do. You don't want these wires all loose and hanging.
No.
Don't try trimming them, because otherwise you're going to have a lovely stem and then it'll disappear. So make sure you tape all the way down to make sure that that's
I just
even.
Can't believe how realistic this is.
Now I'm going to trim that off at the bottom. Now I'm going to look at it, and as you can see, it's all moved and gone a bit higgledy-piggledy. So very gently, we're just going to bring them up. And can you see, this is why you want them wet, so that you can move them back into place. Now I'm going to turn the airbrush back on. Make sure it's the right colour, because then I can start tinkering with the petals and making them darker, just on the edges there. You can see they've got a bit of depth going on now.
Beautiful.
Let's just add a little bit more of that colour. Oh, I've added too much. That's why you have a piece of tissue hiding under here, so that you can just mop up the mess. Here's me saying you only need a little drop, and I put about 20 in then. So I'm just doing right in the centre there. Like so.
That's
there's
beautiful,
my cosmos.
Isn't it? Take a look at that. Work of art. All done live before your very own eyes, and all really we've used is the Wilton paste, which is the flour paste, as opposed to the other paste that we showed earlier on, the Renshaw.
Yeah.
You're using the Wilton, which is more for flowers and petals.
It is, yeah. Okay. It rolls much finer, as you can see the detail.
A few of the tools as well, which you'll find on the website as well, from Wilton, the Wilton tools. Let's actually just run through everything that we've just been using. Let's start with the airbrush first of all, if you'd like to go for that and add that to your order. Here it comes. And again, this is a must-have for anyone that's into cake decorating. This is going to be an absolute godsend to have this by your side. You do get a training DVD, of course, with Cassie as well, and you do get four of the colours that you can see. Actually, three colours and one cleaning solution is what you get included. Plus, you get the main machine, the main compressor, which is incredibly whisper quiet, and also the pen too. That's on FlexiPay. Now, that means basically, provided you live in this country and you've got a debit or a credit card that's in date, you can spread the cost, if you wish, over three interest-free payments. Now, that is just £30 today, plus the PMP, and then automatically your debit or credit card will be deducted with the next £30 in 4 weeks, and then the final payment in 8 weeks. If you want to pay for it in full, that's absolutely fine, but remember that price of £89.99 is only there if you're in the Create and Craft Club. So if you want to join today, it's £20 to become a member for a whole year, and that gives you, of course, a whole year's 10% discount at least, very often more than that, but standard is 10% off everything that you buy from us. We then moved on to our cutters and also our fantastic moulds as well. Now you get two of the moulds to give the veining of the petals, and you also get two of the cutters as well. We used both of those actually for both of the flowers that we've done in the show. And that is new today, and it's £17.99 if you're in the club, or £19.99 if you're not. Now the wire and the tape that Cassie's been using as well, this is the white floral wire and the tape bundle, that's £13.49, and you get an awful lot there, different gauges as well depending on what type of flower you're making, 357, 759. Now this is the Wilton paste that we've been using for the petals. I know lots of you are adding this to your order today, and don't forget everything Wilton, everything that they have actually got on offer for sale is in stock here at Create and Craft. We're the only place in the United Kingdom that stocks the entire Wilton inventory. If you want to have a little browse through that, it's at createandcraft.tv right now. But if you want that, the ready-to-use gum paste for the petals, that's £9.44 to club members, £10.49. If you're not, 351 034 here at the Cake Academy.
It always amazes me just how quickly these hours go. Thank you for tuning in. This is only the third ever show in the Cake Academy. Every Sunday at 5 o'clock, we'll do a new one. Cassie's our guest this particular day today. And remember, the previous two shows, if you're just finding this today, thinking, oh, I missed the first one and the second one, you can watch those back if you want to at the website, createandcraft.tv. They're there under the Cake Academy section. So Rosie's there, and last week's show's there as well. Here we are. If you missed a lesson, you can watch them back on your tablet or on your PC, or even through your TV, if you've got like a smart TV these days, you can do that. So there we go. But we've got about 7 minutes left. I know we'd want to have a little look at some of these fantastic works of art that are just here in front of me at the moment, because they are gorgeous, all completely edible.
Yes,
that's
all
the
sugar.
Most amazing thing.
Yeah.
All sugar. Wow.
So even the flower pot that the orchids are standing in is a cake.
Wow.
There.
That is a cake.
Yeah.
Unbelievable.
And airbrushed,
and
obviously.
All of them, yeah, most of them have been airbrushed as well. And even this napkin ring just here as well. I know we're going to be kind of showing the mould that's made this in just a second. And we've got some moulds on the website as well if you want to see these. But beautiful, absolutely gorgeous. Have you got another demo that you can do in the next 5-6 minutes?
Well, I've got too many.
Oh.
I'm struggling. Yes, yes, we haven't. Can I have another hour? Is that okay?
Yeah, well, maybe you can come back another time.
That'd be nice. Okay. Right, so loads of lovely moulds here as well. So if what I've just shown you now scared you to death, if you're quite, you know, not up to that standard, that's fine. There's so many things out there now that makes your life easy. And these here are just some superb moulds. We've got Karen Davis moulds here, and we've got Katie Sue's Designs. Mm-hmm. So they're all beautiful, beautiful moulds, and I've got samples of them that I've done there. But just to show you, we'll show you the napkin ring, because
yeah.
I think coming up to Christmas...
This is one of the Karen Davis moulds, by the way, this
that's
one.
Quite nice. So this is the mould here, really good quality. We're going to use the corn flour. This is just to stop it sticking.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'm going to get a sausage of paste. Now, I've changed pastes, let me inform you. I've
now
gone to Renshaw flour and modelling paste. You can do flours with it, but I find that they don't roll quite as thin.
Right.
So I tend to use it more for this kind of thing.
So the petals was the Wilton.
Yeah.
And for the moulds, we're using the Renshaw.
Yeah.
That's the kind of rule of thumb.
Yeah. Well, the thing is, work which one works for you. Mm. Does that make sense? You know, it might not work for me, it might work for you. And I find that a lot. We're all different, aren't we? So we just roll this into a sausage, and then what I'm going to do is start one side of the mould, and we gently press in, and I'm pressing quite firm, because that's the thing with this, I'm pressing really firm. Now, if I was to do this with the Wilton one, it would be like chewing gum, it'd start coming up again.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a huge difference in the pastes.
Well, it's things like that information that very often you wouldn't be told. So, you know, if you're struggling with a certain paste because you've got the wrong thing for the wrong job,
yeah.
Then this is Renshaw paste for the moulds and Wilton paste for the petals.
That's it. So we press down,
mm-hmm.
Get nice and firm. And then all we're going to do is start peeling away. And look at that.
Oh, wow.
Beautiful.
So
with
anyone
this,
is going to get results like this.
Yeah, instant. And I just think they're lovely. They're really lovely moulds. Now, if I just go to the cake over here, now there's nothing stopping me putting that as a border around the cake, and that's what they're used for, really.
Mm.
And that looks lovely on its own.
It does.
Airbrushed.
And that's done
different
in seconds.
Colours. Yeah, instant effect.
And this is actually allowed to dry, obviously. It's now solid, but it makes a gorgeous napkin ring. You
yeah.
can use elements of it and just use small parts of it, possibly as cupcake toppers as well, if you wanted to.
Exactly. There's one here that's round, and that is perfect for the top of the cupcake. You see the pink one over there?
Mm-hmm.
So that's a perfect one for the top of the cupcakes.
Isn't that great? Now, we have got quite a few moulds on offer. We've got 3 moulds, in actual fact. 3 of them, I believe, are Karen Davis. Yeah, they're all Karen
yeah.
Davis in the show, but Katie Sue moulds you'll find on the website. Here's the first one. So this is the Karen Davis filler flowers mould. So you've actually got about 3 designs in one
There's
there.
There's 3, yeah, they're on yeah. here. If I take those off, those are the... Yeah.
Those are the
one,
3, yeah?
1, 2, 3.
Yeah.
There.
There. Okay, so that's what these moulds will make.
Yeah.
This is again the Renshaw paste.
It is, yeah. Yeah, that's all I've used. And airbrushed them.
So that's what they make. £13.49 if you're in the Create Craft Club for that one. 357750. Now, the one that we just used to make the border on the cake, or indeed the napkin wrap, if you want to use it for that too, this is the hydrangea border mould from Karen Davis. And that's also new today too. And then the cupcake mould, which is this one, which we showed you the pink cake a few seconds ago, that's the topper for that particular cake. It's £10.79. But you'll get perfect results every single time.
Yeah.
And things like Renshaw paste as well, you'll find on the website. It's in white, which is the most popular, but there are other colours as well.
There are, yeah. And you could always get maybe a paler pink and then airbrush just the edges, and that looks lovely. And on the napkin ring, and if I just show you this one here that I reach over for, you can see I've airbrushed that in a red, but then I've just tipped the edges with gold, because I'm thinking Christmas already on there. So it's just quite nice.
Superb. Well, now, for anyone that's enjoyed the show and is thinking about taking up cake decorating or whatever, what would you say the first couple of things that you need to buy so that you're equipped?
The essential kit. Buy your tools.
Right.
So you've got your tools. The Wilton tools are all in that little box. They're ideal. Your board is essential. Scissors, good, fine quality scissors are essential. Scalpel.
Okay.
With those things, you can do anything. You really can.
And you'll find it all on the website, crankcraft.tv. That's your one-stop shop now for anything cake decorating. This slot every Sunday is always going to be, for the foreseeable future anyway, cake decorating. Next week, Liz Marek is our guest next week, so that's going to be with me as well for a whole hour between 5 and 6 next Sunday. So whatever you do, make sure you tune in for that. Or if you can't tune in every Sunday at 5, maybe you work shift work or whatever, or you've got family commitments, you can series record all of these shows and every show that's related to it as well. If we have like a show with Cassie on a Wednesday at 2 o'clock or something like that, because Cassie's on it, it'll be series linked and recorded, okay? So, all you have to do is go to the website crankcraft.tv to find everything that's in the show, but you can series link if you're a Sky viewer. Now, the details of the airbrushing machine, which is what Cassie brings us, and it's a brilliant tool to have. It really, really is. It's under £100. It's £89.99. If you're in the Crate and Craft Club. If you're not, you can still buy it, but it's £99.99 to you, so it makes sense to actually become a member and then join us each week for the shows and enjoy your 10% off everything that you buy from us. It's also on 3 interest-free flexi pays as well, so it's only £30 today if you're a Crate and Craft Club member, plus the P&P of just £2.99. And then you can enjoy all of these fantastic techniques that we've shown you in the show today. Cassie, thanks ever so much.
It's over already.
It's over.
Oh, no.
Another Cake Academy is done and dusted. Do remember to join us next week, though, every Sunday at 5 o'clock, and we'll see you in Birmingham.
Lovely. See you there.
Thanks a lot for watching.
Cake Masters magazine is one of the UK's leading cake decorating monthlies. It includes fabulous step-by-step cake tutorials, recipes, expert advice, competitions, interviews, design inspirations, and so much more. You can order your 12-month subscription to Cake Masters magazine right here for just £35 and with free UK P&P.